All right, so before we can talk about genome assembly, we have to first talk about how the data gets generated. So with whole genome sequencing, basically because of limitations of the devices, we cannot just sequence an entire chromosome from end to end. Instead, these devices can only sequence small chunks called reads. So as a result, to get around this, scientists create multiple copies of the genome using a process called PCR. And then using these multiple copies, they basically randomly chop them up into little tiny pieces and then sequence those tiny fragments. And the result is that we generate read pairs where, given a fragment of known length, we have two reads at either end of them that we know what the sequence is. And then as a result, once we have these reads, we want to basically line them up together and somehow stitch them together to regenerate the entire genome, which you can see at the bottom of the screen. Unfortunately, this drawing is a little bit deceptive in that it seems like we know where each read came from, but in reality, with these sequencing devices, we don't know anything about the reads. All we know is the sequence, but we don't know anything about order, position, anything like that. So as a result, we're somewhat blind in this process. So instead, we use tools like SPADES, a genome assembler, to be able to figure out how the best possible stitching of these reads may be to generate that entire genome. And if you're interested in learning more about what algorithms go on behind these genome assembly tools, feel free to check out the genome assembly chapter of the textbook.